In this video, we're going to explore strategy as an integrated approach. How not only can strategy be viewed as multiple different things, but how it can be multiple different things at once. And I believe when you can hold these multiple perspectives together, then you become much more effective, dynamic, and flexible in being a strategic thinker. Now, to use this, we're actually going to borrow a model that is inherently an academic model from a guy named Henry Mintzberg, one of the true forefathers, founding fathers of strategic thinking. What I particularly love about Henry Mintzberg's approaches is, one, that he does allow for multiple answers at once. He doesn't really define strategy as one and only one thing. Second is that he's really open about how he's learned and evolved his thinking over time. And you can even see from one version of a book to the next, he'll talk about how the book has changed based on how his thinking has changed. So the model we're going to use to explore is called the 5 P's of strategy. And it's basically 5 different ways to explore strategy. I'll provide a few examples as we go, but particularly we'll talk about how these become one integrated whole. Or if you can do all 5 of them, you are in a great position to be a strategic thinker. Now the first is strategy as plan. This is perhaps the most traditional answer. This is the one that many of the textbooks, the authors, the researchers would focus on because it's the most tangible form in which it often takes. Essentially, it's a consistent, conscientiously intended a course of action. Something that planners really drive and then put into action. And so this strategy as plan is the perhaps most common, certainly the most traditional answer of these 5 P's. The next is ploy. This is a specific maneuver intended to outwit a competitor. This is where you might not have gone in with a plan, but you've used a ploy to react to what you're reading. In the message of, you know, no market plan ever survived the first interaction from the customer, because you don't know exactly what's going to happen with your customer, with your competition, with the market as a whole. And so ploy is an angle and approach to outwit. A great example of this is General George Patton. He certainly would have a plan when he went in, but if you really look at it, he would read the situation with his competition and then concoct a ploy to outwit that competition. These were his most brilliant moments in battle, which is a great learning place for strategy. Now, where we see this the most is perhaps the market owner within a company or a general manager, someone that really, you know, is responsible for the P&L and has been carved out, not just a business, they may not be the founder, but they've been allocated a certain market perspective. And so that market is now shaped and they're trying to beat that competition. Those ploys are all about trying to beat the competition. And then the third, is the pattern. This is really a consistency in behavior over time across a stream of different actions. So what is the pattern of decisions and actions across that stream? Well, whether that's intended or not intended, that becomes a strategy. Now, a great example of this is Google. You know, Google doesn't set off and have this great plan where they say, these are the markets, these are our positions, this is our plan, and then goes and executes. They have a pattern of how they operate, of exploration, of customer focus, of trying new things, making sure they have users before they have revenue. And so this pattern has evolved as they both thrive and invest in businesses as well as how they kill them. Now these are often the approach to strategy when you have a strong leader, and the thought process, the behavior of that strong leader is really what shapes that strategy, because the decisions and actions that person takes over time, that becomes the pattern and that becomes the strategy. The 4th P is position. This is essentially locating your organization in the environment. It's about differentiation in relation to your competitors. Often shows up as a matrix with two different dimensions picked and all the competitors mapped out, and you find the one spot where you can differentiate. This is an approach most often used with data-driven consultants, where they can pull the data for you and show where you fit into the market. There's not much intuition as there is research to really understand how to do that. Now, Jack Welch was a significant perspective on position, not just be number one or number two, but how do you differentiate to become number one or number two? There's many whole markets that have sprung up with the objective of someone looking at positioning themselves differently than the rest of the market is shaped. So fast casual dining is a good example of this. While there's many examples, it was trying to find space in the map between sit-down dining and fast food. And so fast casual became a whole new market segment that started up because it was trying to position itself in relation to others. Concierge healthcare is another example of trying to find a new space on a competitive map of looking to where to position. The fifth is perspective. This is really an ingrained way of viewing the world, a worldview, if you will, and usually really comes from a thought leader, a founder, a thought leader who has a perspective, and that perspective shapes everything else that goes on in the organization. Steve Jobs is an example of such a leader. His perspective, his worldview, if you will, is shaped by an awful lot of different things, but it manifested itself in the product strategy, the portfolio, even the specific design traits, how it was sold, how they dealt with competition, where fundamentally it was a lot less about a plan and a lot more about Steve Jobs and his worldview and how the company should operate. Now, before you worry about picking one, the real goal is to be able to do all five, to have all five in your wheelhouse so that you can integrate them, put them together, and be flexible enough to operate on any one of those dimensions. If you end up too one-dimensional from a strategic standpoint, you might have a great plan, but it's beaten by a very courageous ploy. You might have a great pattern that works, but someone outpositions you and still beats you. The point is that you want to be able to play in multiple dimensions as a strategic thought leader. Two examples that I can think of this are Jeff Bezos and Sir Richard Branson. If you look at each of them, you could probably attribute every single one of those five things to that leader. In fact, I did this as I was going through this list and saying, where do they belong? Well, they didn't belong in any one of those categories because they belonged in all five. And because of this, that makes them very flexible leaders, very flexible strategic thinkers, and ultimately makes them effective for all days, not just a few of them. So even if you don't aspire to be all five at once, at least look at the map, figure out where you have strengths, and figure out how you can build strengths to enhance what you already have. And this fundamentally will make you a stronger, more flexible, more dynamic strategic thought leader.